myself, Amit Mehra. I'm the CMD of Medico Electrodes International Limited. We manufacture disposable ECG electrodes. I started my career in late 1990s and started this company in around 2002. Today we are the third largest producer of this item in the world. We have close to 80-85% of Indian market share and about 15-18% of world market share. And we are the largest outside the US. So it's been a considerable growth opportunity that we have seen. I think talking about the, and now we are focusing on the little, what you call, very tough markets like Japan, China. So we have seen the products coming all the way from Japan and China to India. But this is one of the few products, I think, which is not very successfully made there. But even if it's made, it's not made to the best of the prices and the best. So there is a lot of scope available, but yes, due to very tough registration processes and everything, so we are trying to enter into these tough markets, China and Japan, and let's see how it progresses. So that is the second phase of what we are trying to do. All going well, I think in the next 5 years, we will turn out to be the largest producer of this kind of product in the world. So that's what the aim is. And talking about the healthcare sector, I think healthcare sector in India has just started. Like many other sectors, I think it is just not even a few percentage, I would say a single percentage points of what will happen, because I don't think so that apart from, even in the tier one states or tier A towns that we call, we have adequate medical facility available. So even if you move, say, 50-60 kilometers outside Delhi, at least, I don't know about Mumbai, but you don't have any kind of healthcare. God forbid, if anything happens, even on the road, you don't have adequate medical facilities available. So there is a lot of scope in the healthcare sector. The only taboo being, it's a very technology-driven sector, very highly controlled so far by Europeans and Americans. So the scope exists, and wherever there existed a scope of first entry level, I think it's a very there is just a lot of opportunity. But again, as I said, you have to be very it's a technology driven, so how do you get hold of the right kind of technology is a little challenge. And just to add up to, I've been listening to the panelists and the fellow entrepreneurs, I think it requires very huge amount of courage to do a business in India. It's not at all any kind of ease of doing business in India. So even if we now see some government policies, which I've been hearing that the government is announcing, that's what we should see tomorrow. But all the entrepreneurs who have done what they're today has been largely without any. So you might, I've been seeing people talking about financial supports and everything. But I think even if you do have some kind of financial support, you have to create your complete infrastructure. So you have to create a business, you have to create a full infrastructure. You do not have adequate electricity, you do not have water, which are very essential to run the plant. There are no labor laws, but the labor laws are still dated back to 1947, like many of our other laws. So it's very hard to do business in India, and it really requires courage. And kudos to all who can do it. And taking it from Prahlad, who said, you really require a huge amount of courage to do business in India. So it's very tough, but yes, few courageous people have been able to turn it around. And I think they are doing it much better than China, where China provides huge amount of infrastructure support, and here we have none. So I think anybody who has made successful in India is far placed than anybody in China or any other part of the world. Thank you.
Thank you. Do you see any opportunity for India becoming an export hub in any way for any of the medical devices, instruments? You know, like you do have in pharma some kind of presence in the global market, but in devices,
I think it can happen, but as I said, infrastructurally we are way, way, way far behind. Okay. I think how much time, 10 years, 20 years it will take, because government is doing too many things, but I don't see anything happening at all on the infrastructure sector. So if you don't have infrastructure, how do you then you actually require too many courageous people to turn it around. A regular guy will just get Either apart from all the challenges, you still have to face the infrastructure challenges. That's the, you don't have roads, you don't have electricity, so generate your own electricity. So if you're running, if you have to have a 250 kVA, say, electricity connection, you have to have a 500 kVA genset ready. So it's very challenging. Anything is doable, but again, it requires a huge amount of government support. Infrastructure is something that you really can't build on your own.